Ganguly, MD Infectious Diseases, Chairman of the Advanced Center of Virology in India.
So I'm Irmina van Dyken, MD.
This nitric oxide is present normally in our body.
Humming can actually increase the movement of these nitric oxide molecules.
It will also protect people working in the intensive care unit. It comes as a great hope.
My name is Pratesh, and I'm honored to have Dr. Ganguly and Dr. van Dyken with me today. And we are here to talk about our hypothesis about a breathing technique based on the most recent scientific advancements to potentially prevent COVID-19 infection. So first things first, it is very important to note that this breathing technique called humming breathing or four-hum breathing cannot replace the vaccines or any other treatments, but it can be a safe, effective, and zero-cost method to support such preventative and curing treatments. As a disclaimer, there are no clinical trials performed on this breathing technique yet, and our paper is not peer-reviewed as well. Also, this research is not associated or sponsored by any organization. It is part of our own personal research with no commercial benefits anticipated. We are not claiming that this breathing technique will definitely work to prevent or cure COVID-19. However, as a group, we believe that this concept involves just humming, and one can safely practice this unless suggested by a doctor, of course. So with that said and taken care of, so let's learn more about this breathing technique and most recent scientific advancements behind it. So Dr. Ganguly and Dr. van Dyken, very welcome. Can you throw some light on your background, expertise, and how long you have been in the medical field? I'll start with you, Dr. Ganguly.
I'm Nirmal Ganguly. I did my MD in infectious diseases and from PGI Chandigarh, and rose from there as a professor of experimental medicine and biotechnology, and later on the director of the institute. Later on, I joined as an in Director General of Indian Council of Medical Research. And at the current moment, I'm the chairman of the Advanced Center of Virology in India and foundation and chairman of the Immunology Foundation.
Thank you, Dr. Ganguly. We are honored and humbled to have you here. Thank you so much. Dr. van Dyken, would you mind quickly introducing yourself?
Sure. So I'm Irmina van Dyken. I got my MD at the University of North Dakota, and I'm a surgeon. So by trade, I do surgeries. My interests beyond surgery include nutrition, lifestyle medicine, and now nitric oxide.
Great. Thank you so much. So let's quickly begin this. Dr. Ganguly, can you tell us more about the clinical properties of nitric oxide, the medical properties, specifically against COVID-19 infection? And can you also talk about the Canadian company Sanitizer's clinical trial and a little bit more information beyond that?
Actually, nitric oxide is a molecule which can kill organisms, and it can kill viruses, it can kill bacteria, and it can kill parasites and even fungi if given in appropriate dosages. This molecule can also cause dilatation of the blood vessels, and through this dilatation it can push oxygen. It is actually one of the only molecules which works in the pulmonary hypertension. And this is also one of the molecules which can work on the prevention of cerebral edema and the lung edema in the higher altitude. This nitric oxide is present normally in our body, and it could be induced also through inducible nitric oxide mechanisms. So this is present in our nasal sinuses, and can be released through the vibration in the nasal cavity. At the moment, many people are working on nasal shields of various kinds, where there are substances which when you coat the nose with, it can prevent the entry of virus as well as it can kill the viruses. However, they are all external and artificial, whereas nitric oxide is present in our body and runs vital functions. There is a company known as Sanitize. This company, along with the researchers in UK as well as in Israel, have produced a substance which is which can produce nitric oxide when the reagents are mixed, while the deliverable bottle is squeezed, and it sprays the nose with the nitric oxide, and it can kill about 98% of the viruses by the second day. This is a very fragile molecule and can get destroyed very quickly. So it is sprayed several times in a day, and has come as a boon because this can work on the various mutants which at this given moment in country like India, the situation is very grim. So under these circumstances, this can be a real boon to bring down the viral load. I will finish by saying that it will also protect people who are working in the intensive care unit. Many doctors or health caregivers who are vaccinated or double vaccinated are getting infected because they get a heavy dose of the virus. And some of them get into fatal infection, although 99% get milder infection. So this will protect them also. So at this given moment, it comes with as a great hope for the future.
Great. Thank you, Dr. Ganguly. So this nasal spray, you can spray in your nose and it can protect you from the virus and also kills 99% of the COVID-19 virus. So, and I'm assuming this nasal spray would probably be coming to India. I know they are running their phase 3 clinical trials, but it would be at least few weeks, if not months, before it's manufactured and distributed in India. So it will take time.
Actually, several Indian companies are working on producing it, and there are others who are trying to negotiate with the company to get this spray as soon as possible in India and do a quick validation study in our country.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for that update. So while we are waiting for those nasal sprays and nitric oxide-based treatments to reach people, Dr. Van Dyken, so humming and the production of nitric oxide in your nose and 15-time increment while humming, so that is one of the key reference in our review paper. Can you discuss that in more detail?
Sure, I'd be happy to. When we look at our face, we actually have what we call paranasal sinuses. And these are these sinuses, these reservoirs that sit in our bones, in our skull. So we have frontal sinuses, we have sinuses here. There's actually a few different types of sinuses. They're big reservoirs and they store nitric oxide. We know they store nitric oxide, but only recently did we find out that they can actually, through a certain process, a type of humming, they can release this nitric oxide into the nasal passages. So this was first discovered and postulated in 2006 by some scientists at the Karolinska Institute in Sweden. The Karolinska Institute, it's a very famous place. It has a good reputation. The people that are on the Nobel Laureate Committee, so the people who decide who gets Nobel Prizes, they come from there at the Karolinska Institute. So scientists at this institute actually researched. They did some experiments to prove their hypothesis that humming can actually increase the resonance in your sinuses. It can increase the movement of these nitric oxide molecules and cause them to be excreted into the nasal passages. The humming has to be fairly particular at a certain resonance. So 130 hertz is what they described in the paper, which is a very low tone. And that tone can cause these nitric oxide molecules to move very, very fast. If any of you know what a Helmholtz resonator is, it's similar to that. And it causes these molecules to exit the sinuses, exit the reservoirs, and get into the nasal passages. So that's how that worked.
Great. Thank you, Dr. Van Eyken. That's very helpful. So if the aim is to generate maximum nitric oxide in your nose at high concentrations through humming, the obvious question is how much humming to do and for how long? So thankfully, these questions were also answered through strong scientific literatures and publication. The most notable one, obviously, is the Karolinska Institute thesis in Sweden, as you can see on the screen. So in this thesis titled Humming Nitric Oxide and Paranasal Sinus Ventilation, there's actually a discussion about an experiment where these nasal sinuses of a healthy person were punctured, and the scientists were astonished to find high concentration of nitric oxide in paranasal sinuses. So when you hum, highly concentrated nitric oxide from your sinuses is channeled to your nose through this amazing mechanism called Helmholtz mechanism. Well, my vibration engineering background comes handy here. So this amazing spring mass type system called Helmholtz resonation induces some of the nitric oxide from your sinuses to your nasal cavity. Now, don't forget that several researchers have proved that the COVID-19 virus first sits in your nose. For example, this UNC research. So when the COVID-19 virus sits in your nose, the point is this increased nitric oxide through humming in your nasal cavity can actually reduce at least some of the viruses in your nose. So when you hum, nitric oxide is channeled and some of the viruses can be killed. Interestingly, in the traditional bee humming, Brahmari Pranayama yogic exercise, one gently pushes their sinuses and performs humming to release more nitric oxide. That's a very interesting perspective we brought in our paper. But more interesting, this thesis, the Karolinska Institute thesis, also mentions that after 4 rounds of humming, one need to take a break of at least 3 minutes. Now, why this 3-minute break? Well, this 3-minute break helps your sinuses to refill nitric oxide. The Karolinska Institute thesis talks about this on page 23. Additionally, a research paper at European Respiratory Journal actually shows how nitric oxide production in your nose is almost flattened after 4 rounds of humming. So after this is after first round of humming, really high concentration of nitric oxide, second hum, third hum, and after 4 hum. So one hum is hum. So that's one hum. So after second, third, fourth, the nitric oxide production is flattened, and you have to wait for 3 minutes before it reaches the maximum limit. After 3 minutes of break, again, you can start humming, but for 4 times. So the bottom line is 4 rounds of humming and then a break of at least 3 minutes before one begins the next round. That's the way to do it. One can do this for 15 minutes in the morning and 15 minutes in the evening. So given that background, Dr. Ganguly, for non-medical folks like me, right? I'm an engineer, I understand the concept of vibration, but we don't understand the medical properties of nitric oxide. How safe is this humming method to produce natural nitric oxide? Do you anticipate any side effect of this natural humming at all?
Actually, I don't anticipate any side effect because its concentration is exactly right to kill. It is not a huge amount which is released. Even when you give nitric oxide artificially as a spray, it's a very fragile gas. It breaks down through a pathway which is known as citrulline to nitrite, which is an inert substance. For nitric oxide to really have a larger staying power, it has to be with the inert gases like argon or helium. So nitric oxide is very safe. Secondly, nitric oxide, we generate free radicals within our body. Nitric oxide combines with them to make nitroxy peroxides, and these nitroxy peroxides then can kill organisms. free radicals could damage, but nitric oxide doesn't really damage. However, in a very large concentrations, if it gets into the eyes and others artificially, there could be some eye damage, but within our body, it doesn't cause any damage in the mucosal surfaces. So it is very, very safe.
Great. Thank you. It's comforting for someone like me that it's safe. I can perform humming, generally safe, unless obviously suggested by a doctor for any reason. So Dr. Van Dyken, has there been any clinical trials in the past that shows that you can actually cure something, some infection in your nose through humming? I mean, it sounds great in theory, but in practice, has anyone done this before? Like just by humming, you fix something in your nose, like an infection or something?
Yeah, that's a really good question. And there's not been a large study, a huge randomized study, for example, but there's a case report that happened. So just one person, he was a 64-year-old, and he reported that he cured himself from what we call rhinosinusitis, which is a chronic thing. It's chronic infection and inflammation of your sinuses. And this gentleman, basically, he said he reversed it in 4 days. He did a pretty significant protocol. He hummed quite a bit. The first day he hummed for over an hour, and it was 18 hums per minute. He went to bed, he woke up the next day, and he said it was the first day in years that he could breathe through his nose. So he continued to hum. He hummed for 4 days at 130 hertz, just like the paper talked about. And he described 60 to 120 hums in 4 sessions per day. And what did he find? Well, his symptoms improved and improved until after 4 days, he said he was completely cured. So yeah, it's just one person, one story, one report. It would be nice to have a study where we look at many people and trial this compared to a placebo or some other drug, but the one study is very encouraging.
Thank you. Thanks. And, you know, similarly, one can perform this humming exercise a few times a day and then continue to do this for days. And there are tons of benefits to this breathing exercise, and we'll talk about that. In past clinical trials, this breathing exercise, including the Brahmari Pranayam, traditional bee humming breathing exercise, can lower your blood pressure. Past clinical trials have proven that it reduces stress, better quality of sleep, improved heart health, like Dr. Ganguly said. Interestingly, Dr. Louis Ignaru, who received a Nobel Prize for discovering certain properties of nitric oxide, a few months back, he actually mentioned about humming and nose breathing to potentially prevent COVID in your body. So in the last few months, he has been part of several online interviews discussing the positive effects of nitric oxide in your body. So we'll reference the link below in the interview. However, two cautions. First, don't do it extreme, like humming for nonstop for hours. We don't recommend that. No one knows what's the side effect if you continue to hum for nonstop for hours, 15 minutes in the morning, 15 minutes in the evening, and intermittently during the day you can hum, but follow the protocol, 4 hums and 3 minutes of break. The other thing is, do not confuse nitric oxide with nitrogen dioxide, which is NO2. Again, nitric oxide is NO, the chemical formula is NO, and nitrogen dioxide is a very different chemical with an extremely different properties. Don't confuse. Another chemical that can be confused is nitrous oxide, which is N2O. Again, very different chemical, do not confuse. Just like H2O is water and H2O2 is hydrogen peroxide, and they're very different chemicals. Similarly, nitric oxide, NO, is the chemical that we are talking about, and that has the most beneficial properties that we discuss. With that said, Dr. Ganguly and Dr. Van Dyken, thank you so much for contributing to this and suggesting this technique. Hopefully this can be beneficial to people around the world. The paper is being submitted. Hopefully we should have reviews pretty soon. We are planning to make it public on preprint in a few days. We are also working to see if actual clinical trials can run on this method. We are working on the protocols for that. So hopefully good news ahead. So thank you, Dr. Van Dyken, and thank Dr. Ganguly. Dr. Van Dyken, thank you so much. I know it's 6:37 a.m. your time, and you will be performing surgery in a few minutes, but thank you again.
Yes, yes. One other thing I wanted to add just before we close, I just wanted to stress, we don't want to do humming when we are in a situation where it could be dangerous, say like driving or something like that. So you want to make sure you are not actively driving a vehicle or whatever it happens to be, or riding your bike. You want to do it when you're in a safe place.
That's it. Thank you so much. Appreciate your time. Very helpful.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.